Lots of awards will be somewhere between these extremes. If you happen to enter a competition with the hottest business, entrepreneur, or charity on the block at that particular time, luck might be against you and you might struggle to win. That's just down to your 5% luck factor, which can be good as well as bad. However, you can still gain a lot of benefit by even being a finalist in the competition, shouting about it on social media and aligning your brands publicly, so it's not all bad. The good news is that leaves you with control over around 95% of your chances of success, but only if you enter awards strategically, like the most successful awards persona we have found, the athlete. Become an awards athlete. Imagine how Olympic athletes plan, prepare, and train to win, to give themselves the best chance of success. Gold medal winning Team GB Paralympian Neil Fahey is a perfect example. He has won 27 medals at major championships to date, 20 of which were gold. This includes gold and silver at the London 2012 Paralympic Games and gold at the Tokyo Paralympics 2021. As a full-time athlete and now co-founder of a business performance coaching company, Neil often shares his thoughts on the similarities between sport and business. One theory that I believe crosses over between sport and business is the famous marginal gains philosophy, developed by Sir David Brailsford. This has created outstanding results for many gold medalists like Neil and for sports legends like Sir Chris Hoy. Brailsford believed that if it was possible to make a 1% improvement in a whole host of areas, the cumulative gains would end up being hugely significant. This means analysing absolutely everything that could impact upon performance, from the material of the clothing the athlete wears, to the comfort of the bed they sleep on, which influences the amount of rest they get at night. Everything that could make a marginal difference to performance and results is assessed and improved before they compete. On their own, these differences may seem meaningless, but put together, they add up to give this cyclist the best advantage over their competitors, making a tiny points of a second difference in their completion time and giving them a better chance to win. But it's not just vital to analyse your business as you work towards your first award, but also to reflect and review when you don't win and use the feedback you get to become better and stronger for your next awards challenge. Remember that analogy, you either win or you learn. Neil recently spoke to me on my podcast and here's how it works in action. Neil says, to be successful in the long term, you constantly have to evolve who you are. As an athlete, you can't train the same way for over a decade and expect to just keep improving. You have to make adjustments and changes. Otherwise, things just become really stale and progression plateaus off to nothing. At the 2016 Paralympic Games in Rio, we were world favourites to win, but we came away with a silver. To me, that was as good as a failure, and I had a lot of fear that it was the beginning of the end of my career. I decided I would have one last attempt at the gold, and we made a lot of changes to the way we approached training and what our focuses were. My performance started going through the roof, and 18 months later, I competed in the World Championships, which happened to be back in Rio on the velodrome where I lost that gold medal. And then again, 2 weeks later at the Commonwealth Games in Australia's Gold Coast. In the space of 2 weeks, I'd won 2 golds at both events, 4 golds in total, and broken a world record in the process. All because I'd taken that step back, looked at the bigger picture, and realised that I needed to evolve slightly the way I trained. And it's easier said than done, because when you're in the thick of it and you feel like you just need to work hard every single day, the time to just step back and just look at the bigger picture is not always there. However, the learning experiences I've had throughout these challenging times have always been the greatest and have paid dividends in my career. Just think about the few little tweaks you can make to create an advantage.